Right. Give him glory. There is none like him. Hallelujah. Tonight is the fourth night of glory. Wherever you are at the good land in Lekki, I hope you're hearing me clearly. All over the world, this is the fourth night of glory, and we are grateful for the first day, second day, third day, and on this Thursday night, we are just grateful to him. We are just grateful to him. Lift your hands and appreciate him again. Worship him. Give him praise. Thanking him for the year 2015. Praise and adore him. Find a song that you can sing. I'd like you to be relaxed in God's presence. Don't be anxious. Don't be fearful. Just bless the name of the Lord. Bless his name. Mashataka Mankrede. Tonight we want to say thank you, Lord. We lift you high. Yes.
I will worship you, Lord.
Wherever you are,
and my mouth filled with praise, I will worship you, God. Yeah. All I see is you. With my head.
This night, and as we pray, Lord, tonight we receive anointing for supplication. Even as we cry to you in accordance with your word, we receive supernatural answers in the name of Jesus Christ. Just we already have good reports coming in all over the world. We ask that the reports will multiply in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. If you have your Bibles, pick your Bibles. I know we are strong people. Amen. We're going to pray for the next 20, 25 minutes, and then we'll share the word a bit. We're going to pray in agreement, as I mentioned yesterday, in agreement. The Bible says where two or three are gathered together in the name of Jesus is there in their midst. We are gathered here in the name of Jesus. Amen. And we are more than two. We are more than three all over the world. Hallelujah. All over the world. So as we pray in accordance with his word, we believe that we will have answers. And the prayer points we're going to take now are things we do on the behalf of this church. When I said the church, it's not the building, it's not the air conditioners, it's every member of the church their families, extended family, and everyone connected to us. And that we prayed about it last year does not mean we should not pray about it this year. And my focus, the first focus for tonight is deliverance from evil. Deliverance from evil. When you don't fight the enemy to a standstill, the devil begins to oppress. And what you believe is what you eventually become. In some circles, they believe that people can die at any time. All kinds of things can happen to people. It is part of God's plans. I don't believe that. We don't believe that. So we're going to look at God's word briefly while we're standing and see what God has said about evil. The first one is John 10, verse 10. Many of us are familiar with John 10, verse 10, but I like you to even see it so that you won't say they are deceiving you in church. John 10, if you don't have a Bible, look at your neighbor's Bible, but nobody should be looking like Luke was it. Huh? We are here to pray. We are fasting. It's not jamboree. It's not entertainment. Hallelujah. You will not be a victim of evil. No member of this family worldwide will be a victim of evil. John 10, verse 10, the thief cometh not but for to what? Steal and to kill and to what? Who is doing the killing? Who is doing the destruction? The thief. Now, is Jesus Christ the thief? Now, that's the truth. Jesus Christ is not the thief. He says that I am come that they may what? Have life, and that they might have that life more abundantly. So there's a demarcation between what Jesus wants to do or is doing and what the thief, Satan, is doing. So you don't confuse the two and say, ah, it is God that is teaching me by cutting your leg. It is God by that is killing you, that teaching you by causing your accident. No. No. Sometimes when those things happen, it's because we did not deal with it on time. And that's why in a time like this, it's imperative that we pray so that we can walk in that will of God that says life abundantly. Now, in John 17, verse 15. John 17, verse 15. Jesus was praying for us, for his disciples. John 17, verse 15. Are you there? He says, I pray not. This is to let you know that it's not Jesus that is killing and stealing and destroying. He said, I pray not that thou shouldest take them out of the world. God does not want you to die prematurely. He said, I'm not praying that you should take them out of the world, but that thou shouldest do what? Keep. So if he's the one doing the evil, how can he be praying that God should keep us from evil? The truth will set you free. Amen. The truth will set you free in the name of Jesus Christ. So I pray not that thou shouldest take them from this world. God does not want us to die premature out of sickness, out of disease, out of attacks of evil, out of accidents. He said, but I'm asking you that you should keep them from evil. And that's the prayer this evening, the first prayer point. That every member of this family worldwide, that we stand in agreement, in accordance with the prayer of Jesus, in accordance with his word, that we will be kept from evil in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, that evil is perpetrated through many channels. It can come through wicked people that Satan will use, envious people. Attacks can come from friends. The evil can be perpetrated through accidents, through plane crash, all kinds of things. But if you summarize everything, it is stealing, killing, and destroying. Sometimes you see a couple, everything is going on fine, and then one Satan enters the house, and then the devil steals their joy. The devil steals their passion, steals their romance. When you see good things moving out, it's not God, it's Satan. He comes to steal, he comes to kill, and he comes to destroy. So we're going to be praying specifically from Isaiah. But you know what? Let's look at 1 Peter 5. I need us to be loaded with these verses. When you are praying, you won't be praying blanket prayer. Lord, just help us from evil. No, you are saying it specifically. Father, that ministry of the thief will not flourish in our midst. No stealing. Those who are married, the devil will not steal their joy. The devil will not steal their passion. Those who are prospering, the devil will not destroy their businesses. Those who are traveling up and down this year, the devil will not steal their life. He comes to steal, he comes to kill, he comes to destroy. 1 Peter chapter 5, I think verse 8. 1 Peter 5, he said, be what? Are you there this evening? Be sober, be what? That's why even as we move on in this year, don't ever get to a time when you are carried away. No matter how much money you have in your account, no matter how much testimonies you have, gather yourself together. Be sober. The devil attacks when people are overexcited. They just get vulnerable, and then he comes in to attack. So as mature people, learn to be sober. Oh, there will be breakthroughs. We give thanks to God, but your head is still correct. You are still watching. Because the thing you are celebrating about, if you over-celebrate, it can steal it the next day. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom. So we are saying we will not be devoured. Next verse, verse 9, or the next lesson. He said, whom resist steadfast in emotions, faith, knowing that the same things are being, the same attacks. Your other Christians all over the world are going through it. There's nothing new. But you resist by faith. That's why I'm sharing the first, all those verses, that it's not Jesus that is killing or stealing or destroying. No. No. It's the thief. So you have faith that God does not want me to die this year. Ah. When you know that, then when you are praying for members of the church, you are also extending that faith that this guy too should not die. You know that it wants my marriage to be full of life, full of joy. So you pray for others too, that their homes will be kept intact. So we are praying by faith, not with emotions. Not saying, Father, hey, keep us from this Satan. No, they say it's wicked. Help us. That's not faith. God answers faith. Praise the Lord. Isaiah 54. Is moving around like a roaring lion. You know, in the Job we read 2 days ago, I'm walking up and down, to and fro, doing those things in John chapter 10, part A. You understand? He will go to Afghanistan, key 27. From there, move to Pakistan, key 300. From there, go to France, key 12. From there, go to Baga, key 2000. Hello? Perpetrating all kinds, moving up and down. Walking about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. You too, you look at the way those things are happening, you know something is devouring them. The killing, the stealing, the horribleness is Satan. Isaiah 54, verse 13, thereabout. 13. 13. So we're going to be praying with this scripture direct from verse 13 to 17. I hope everyone is listening all over. At Lekki and Goodland, Isaiah 54, verse 13. I'm going to give us time. We're going to pray it. And God has been answering us. We answer us again tonight. He said, all thy children shall be what? No matter which school your child goes to, if God's hand is not upon the child, they can still be wayward. The blessings of the things I have in my life, majority did not come from my parents. There is a way God will organize how a destiny can be preserved. That prayer point is very important. All our children in this ministry, let your hand be upon them. We echo your word to you, Lord, that all our children shall be taught of the Lord. There is a way a child will be hearing the voice of God at 7. And great shall be what? Your children will give you peace. Our children will give us peace. Prosperity plus wayward children is hell. And great shall be the peace of thy children. Verse 14. In righteousness will I be established. I will not be established in corruption, Lord. In righteousness will I be established. I will be far from oppression. We will be far from oppression. And we rebuke fear in the name of Jesus Christ. And look at that next one. Say, and we shall be far from terror. For it shall not come near us. That is a very important prayer. Particularly for the next 4 years. We can't stop birds from flying. But as a family, we can stop the birds from resting over any member of this church. That no matter the wickedness, no matter the evil, it shall not come near us. That is in that verse. It said, thou shalt be, look at it well, oh, thou shalt be far. Is it far or near? Far, far from oppression, for you will not fear. And meaning you shall also be far from terror. For it shall not come near you. Verse 15. Behold, they shall surely gather together, but not by me. Whosoever. I mean, all the conspiracy. They say some family members hate you. They say in the village they are trying to fight you. This one covers all those attacks of wicked people. Either social attack or business attacks where you are in the office and they don't just like you and they begin to conspire against you. Or some people come together, carry your name to the to a herbalist. Whatever. Say, whosoever shall gather together against any of us, they shall fall. Wow, verse 16. Behold, I've created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, and that bringeth forth an instrument for his work, and I've created the waster to destroy. Verse 17. No weapon, whether it's spiritual, whether it's social, whether it's psychological, no weapon that is formed against any member of this family shall prosper. And every tongue that rises against us in judgment, we condemn. This is our heritage, and our righteousness is of the Lord. Glory to God. Are you ready tonight? Are you ready to pray? So you pick your Bibles. I want them to get on the keyboard. Well, just open Isaiah 54 and thank God first for your family, for our families, for our children. And begin to take all those lines one by one and pray not just for yourself, but for every member of this family worldwide. Let's go ahead and pray in the name of Jesus Christ. All our children shall be taught of the Lord. All, not some, all. I release us to pray. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Isaiah 54, verse 13 to 17. All our children shall be taught of the Lord. I'd like the media department to be scrolling those verses one by one. Please, media, from verse 13, you go to 14, you go to 15, you go to 16. Don't rush it. Just leave it a bit and keep rolling it and keep rolling it bit by bit. When you get to 17, you go back to 13 again. We present these scriptures before the Lord. We present these scriptures before the Lord. We are far from oppression. We come against fear. We are far from terror. We are far from terrorism. We are far from jihadists. I commit every member of this church in New York, in Atlanta, in United Kingdom. You will never enter a plane that will crash. You will never enter a train that will be bombed. I speak that you'll be far from oppression and from terror. I speak over every one member of this ministry in Nigeria. I ask for blessings. Hirabasaka, let's pray. Let's pray the word of God. Let's stand in agreement. Isaiah 54, verse 13 to 17. Don't be a spectator. Don't be a spectator. We are releasing the power of God by His word. No weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. No weapon. Political weapon. Psychological weapon. Spiritual weapon. No weapon. No strategy that is against our welfare, that is against the blessings of God, that is against the will of God, none of them shall prosper. Over this church, over this ministry, they shall gather, but not by me. Whosoever, wherever shall gather together against me shall fall for my sake. Against this church, against our ministry, against the families in this church, they shall fall for our sakes. Hallelujah. Release the angels of God in all our journeys this year. Wherever you can hear me, release the angels of God. He shall preserve your going out and your coming in. He said he shall give his angels charge over you. Let us release angels over all our trips, by air, by road, by sea. Angels, he shall give his angels charge over us. They shall keep us in all our ways. I'd like you to pray for all the children this year in the name of Jesus as they go to school, as they go for extra lessons. Please, wherever you are, pray for all the children as they go to school, as they take their school bus, as parents take them to school. Oh, he shall give his angels charge over every child, every baby in the name of Jesus. Release angels of God. Release them in the name of Jesus. He will keep us from evil. He will keep us from horror. name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. He died so we can live. He paid the price for our victory over Satan. I like us, as we close that prayer point, to plead the blood of Jesus over every family represented in this church. He said, when I see the blood, I will pass over. We're going to say, Lord, we plead the blood over our properties, over our children, over our spouses, that whatever evil, no matter in what color, no matter in what dimension, it will pass over. Like Pharaoh was put to shame, the evil is put to shame. Let's pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Plead the blood of Jesus. Cover, cover. Let us run under the cover. There is power in the blood of Jesus Christ. It's the same power. Plead the blood of Jesus over the church. I want to plead the blood of Jesus over good land. The entire area. Shabakasata. Sickly purpose. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus over your husband, over your wife, over your property, even your cars. He said, when I see the blood, I will pass over. So we declare that every evil in whatsoever color, in whatsoever dimension passes over. The evil of witchcraft, the evil of fire, the evil of accidents, it will pass over. Jesus. Father, we thank you. Your word says the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runs into it and is safe. Lord, I present every one member of this family globally. Our families, our children. I bring them under the cover of the name of Jesus. I proclaim that they are safe this year in the name of Jesus. You will preserve our going out and our coming in. We shall be far from oppression. We shall be far from terror. Your word says, gather, they shall gather. So we cannot really stop them from gathering. But whosoever gathers against us, against our welfare, against your plans and purpose, they shall fall flat. In the name of Jesus Christ. 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 Your word says you shall give your angels charge over us to keep us in all our ways. They shall bear thee up lest you dash your feet against a stone. So we present all our journeys this year. Journeys by road, journeys by air, journeys by boat, journeys by sea, journeys by train, journeys by leg. That your angels will go out with us and they will bring us back home safely in the name of Jesus. When we end the year by December, if Christ tarries, no one of us here will be missing in action. In the name of Jesus Christ, I plead the blood of Jesus over everyone under my shepherdhood. The blood of the everlasting covenant. The blood that speaks better words than the blood of Abel. I mark you out. I declare that you shall not be visited with evil. You shall not be tormented by darkness. Man of wicked heart will never be able to oppress you. God will strike terror in their own hearts. God will bring down every Goliath. You will remain standing in the name of Jesus Christ. Isaiah 48, the second prayer point tonight. One of the things I desire for every one of us is that we profit this year. I don't want you to beg for house rent. I don't want any of you to suffer to taking care of your wife and children. It's a major desire in my heart. Rather, I want you to be a giver. To be a blessing. You know, not the reason, because I wish I can do it as a pastor for everybody. But it's not my assignment. That's why you take this next prayer point serious. That was what I had to do for myself. We are to be helpers of others. They should not be carrying us anymore. Isaiah 48 verse 17. Is that correct? Is that correct? 48:17. Yes. Look at this. Thus saith the Lord, thy, are you redeemed? Let the redeemed of the Lord in the house say amen. So this scripture is also for you. He said, thus saith the Lord, thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. I am the Lord thy God, which teacheth thee to profit, which leadeth thee by the way that thou shouldest go. I want this year to be your best prosperity year. You understand me? On your business, on your jobs, to be getting currencies. You know, he said, I am the Lord that teaches you, not your master's degree. And should that not give you joy? It's not my degree in that sense. And maybe you don't know, God teaches people to profit. On your job, there is a kind of inspiration that will come this year. And as you execute that inspiration, you can earn what you've not earned for 10 years. I'm sure you are getting me. Either in a contract you are doing, or you, even if you are a career person, there is something you can do at work this year that will change your story. So this verse, even me, I will pray. There's a way you do your assignment. There's a way you are. There's a way God will teach you. It could be something small. I will just tell you, start dressing like this, and you will have favor. And with that favor, they will give you money.
You know, there's a way you can be and they won't want to give you things. They just hate giving you things. That was the case somebody was sharing with me last week. One guy came to the office and normally they dress casually to the office. So that day, they were to go for a meeting. The guy came in suit, solid neatness. The boss was so excited. Say, you can look like this? And they gave him 300,000. He was so happy. You can look this neat. Favor will follow you. You know why this is important to me? That you don't build doesn't mean people are not building. That you don't travel doesn't mean people are not traveling. That you don't eat well doesn't mean people are not enjoying their life. So don't be angry. The same world. So don't deceive yourself. That you don't have clothes doesn't mean some people don't have wasting clothes. So I don't know what you are doing, whether you are a welder or you are a consultant or you are a pastor. The Lord must teach you to profit. Daniel chapter 1, verse 17. You will not be poor. Your parents will not regret that you were born. There is a way your name passes your mother's heart. On her seat in the village, she smiles. They say, Mama, why did they smile? Don't mind me, I just remember my daughter for Lagos. Not that they remember your name and the east. Whether it's there, I don't know. So get this thing with anger. You can be healthy and be poor. You can be a loving husband and not have money. There are different ministries. There are different principles. You can have the fruit of the spirit and not have fruit of pocket. Are you hearing me now? That woman in scripture says she lost one silver. One silver. And she went to search to get it. Every other area can be okay. One area can be tormenting you. Daniel 1, 27. Is that correct? 17. As for these four children, who gave them? Is it school in that sense? God gave them what? And in all learning and wisdom. And Daniel had understanding. You will have understanding. Eh? You will have understanding. Not them hitting your head every time about your own job. Your own job where you are praying to God for promotion. They are always hitting your head. Do it like this, do it like that. Wake up. They had understanding in all visions and dreams. Next verse. Now at the end of the days that the king had said he should bring them in, then the prince of the eunuchs brought them in before Nebuchadnezzar. Next line. And the king communed with them. And among them all was found none like Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and therefore. Those are the people that stand before kings. Those are the people kings pay for, not the ones that are in the middle or at the back. Next line. And in all matters of wisdom and understanding that the king inquired of them, he found them at the back of the class. Abba, Abba, turn! So when you see the Lord teaching you to profit. Daniel is a classic example. 10 times better. It's like saying 10 times your salary now. At least life will be better, isn't it? If they multiply what you are earning now, no matter how small, times 10, you can start from there, isn't it? Come on. And this is Old Testament too. He didn't have the Holy Ghost. He didn't pray in tongues. Now you can pray chakababa, chakababa. He did not have the Bible. If the ministration of the flesh were that glorious, how much more the ministration of the spirit? Father, I ask that greater than Daniel rise in this church. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now go back to Isaiah 48 verse 17. This one, you're not praying for anybody. You are going to pray. If you like, you can lay your leg on your head or your own hand. Father, you are my God. This year, you will lead me and you will teach me. I surrender my heart. I ask for forgiveness for pride. But Lord, let it be known that you will cause me to profit maximally this year. Isaiah 48, right? Verse 17. So I'm the Lord that teaches you to profit. And then leading. So there are two things. Teaching and those two things from God in your life this year will cause you to profit. If God causes you to profit, it can't be kwekwe money. It can't be kwekwe money. There is a way you run the thing. There's a way you do a presentation. And as you finish the presentation, 10 other clients are lining up. I'm telling you the truth. I've preached in a place before and they gave me $5,000. You know, is that a small thing? Just speaking for 1 hour, for $5,000. Now, if I do that 10 times in a month, won't I be greater than Daniel? Just one meeting, $5,000. Now, if I now do that one 10 times in a month, will I beg you for accommodation money? Look, salary is never your source. It is the blessing, oh. Look at that guy. He just dressed well. He said, just came correct that day. And the boss, he said, instant, I transfer 300 to him now. You, bless you. True story in this Lagos. Not that he was in Kutu Wenje. True story. Do you have a Bible? If you have a Bible, media department, keep that verse there. I release you in 10 minutes. We are going to close with this verse. I will just bless the communion and you will go home. God will teach you. People in this church will be supernatural on their jobs. I mean, you will have colleagues in your office, the same degree, but you now have divine degree. You know, it was that inspiration that made Joseph to interpret. That's what God did to Joseph. Teaching him, this is the dream. 7 years of plenty, 7 years of sorrow. Tell them to do this. An instant from prison to forever prosperity. Thank you, Lord. Go ahead and pray. Ah, Lord, I thank you for my business. I thank you for my job. I thank you for my career. I thank you for the talents you have blessed me with. Talent. Lord, I come to you. What you did in the life of Joseph. And you did in the life of Daniel. I can see it. Isaiah 48, 17. I don't want to beg. There's a better way. Help me. This is my business. Entertainment. Consulting. Pastoring. Export and import. Maritime. As a teacher. As a headmaster. You don't have to steal. But God will help you out. But you will profit maximally. If you're hearing me at Lekki, God wants to give you amazing profits. Uncommon profits this year. God will teach you. And then ask him to lead you. Lead me. Guide me. I don't want to lead myself. You are my shepherd. I shall not want. Teach me, Lord, to do my work. Open my heart. Bless me with ingenuity. Bless me with inspiration. Bless me with understanding. Oh, yet potaka labote, 10 times better, 100 times better. Show yourself up. Open your heart to God. Don't worry. Ask and it shall be given. Doors are opening. Oh my God, doors are opening. You can lay your hands on your head and prophesy. I have the inspiration of God. I have the wisdom of God. I have heavenly strategy. Hey, I am not a dollar though. I know the way to sort it out. I will profit in 2015 to the glory of God. I will not steal. I will profit. I will not cheat. I will be blessed with overflow. Doors are opening.
Lord, I pray for everyone. I pray for this ministry this year. Let your wisdom come. Let your inspiration come. Let your glory descend. Teach us as a ministry to maximize our potentials in the way we handle our resources, in the way we handle our time, in the way we handle opportunities, clients, in the way we handle open doors. Lord, teach us to profit in our businesses, in our careers. Lead us, guide our steps into oil, into blessings, into wealth. Show us like you showed Joseph. Show us what to do. Show us how to do it. We will not live in losses this year. From January to December, we will not live in losses. This ministry, membership, families, businessmen and women, career people will not live in losses. We receive now. We receive, Lord. We receive your blessings. We want to be a blessing. Begin a round of your prayers now. God is good. We must keep asking. We must keep seeking and keep knocking. Until these scriptures be fulfilled this year, you must never stop. You tell him, I serve you. Show me how to manage my clients. Show me how to maximize this client. How to maximize this opportunity. Our help comes from God. In the name of Jesus, lift your hands and thank him wherever you are. Praise the name of the Lord. Shandelebaka, bless the Lord, oh my soul. Bless the Lord. Bless
you. Oh my soul, worship his Lord.
Sing like
never before. Oh, my soul, I'll worship your holy name. The sun comes up
Easter.
It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me
we will be singing. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I bless the communion tables all over the places. And I ask, as we partake of your flesh and your blood, that everyone will find a new level of inspiration. You will not expire in your business. The inspiration of God will lead to more profits. In the name of Jesus Christ. Maybe you enter this year with some debts. By the end of this year, others will be the one owing you money. Maybe you enter this year with losses and financial pain. By the blessing of God teaching you, leading you in your business and career, you are ending this year in overflow. You will be able to buy properties. You will be able to acquire possessions. God will surprise you this year. What your years of experience, what your educational qualification cannot, has not been able to deliver to you, God's wisdom, God's uncommon inspiration, like it happened for Joseph and Daniel, will deliver to you overflowing profit. As you partake of his flesh and his blood, I ask that God will clothe you with his favor. As you step out this year on your business or career, that favor will open doors for you. They will come for you in the palace. They will pay you from the palace. You will get uncommon opportunities. Lord, I wage war against waste. I wage war against prodigal lifestyle. Everyone that has been living under a leaking basket, the leaking basket that is affecting you from prospering them, you will show them where to block the leakages. You will show them how to block the leakages. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, every spirit of waste, we cast it out in the name of Jesus. The inheritance you are bringing our way, rather than we depleting it, it will multiply in our hands. When they are looking for prosperous men, they are looking for multi-millionaires. They are looking for authentic billionaires. They will overfind them in this church. I release you to a new era in your financial journey. I release you to a new season in your career and in your business. Be blessed. A little one shall become a thousand. And a small one shall become a strong nation. Arise and shine. Your light is come. His glory shall be seen upon you. Kings shall come to the brightness of your rising. The abundance of the sea shall be converted to you. And the name of the Lord will be glorified. Lift your hands and give him praise. All over, lift your hands. Lift your hands and praise. I love you, Lord. I praise you, Lord. I bless you, Lord. God has answered our prayers. God has answered our prayers. It's a new day. The doors of oppression is broken down. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We bless you, Lord, for tonight. We thank you for maturity.
Thank you for advancement that cannot be stopped. Thank you for giants rising here. Oh, thank you for gentle billionaires. Thank you, Lord. We are blessed to be a blessing. Your blessing shall not be looked for. It will be abundantly available. We give you the glory. In Jesus' mighty name.